for your brain, for brain health. You're gonna get a little bit of a workout, a little bit of a brain workout, mixing the two together, brain and body. The research shows is probably, hi Irving, mixing brain and body together shows that putting exercise together with brain health is probably the best way for you to keep your brain healthy, build new neurons, prevent dementia, and just generally all over mind and body health. So with that said, we're gonna get going. This morning in my meditation, I did a little something, a guided meditation about intention. And on one of my tools that I use at the end is Yo Baby. And I always tell you guys to set an intention. And setting an intention is anything, and it's up to you. This morning when I meditated, some of the intentions were that they mentioned hope, hopeful, peace, joy, love. Those were some of the intentions that they mentioned. That doesn't mean you have to use that as your intention. But sometimes I wonder if people, you know, when I say set an intention, they understand what setting an intention is. So it doesn't have to be about hope and love and peace and joy, but aren't those wonderful things to set an intention for? So we're not up to that yet, but while I have you here, while we're going to get started, we'll do a little bit of breathing and maybe we can set an intention for the whole Ageless Grace practice. I would like to think that hope would be a great intention right now. New beginnings, it's January. We are in a new administration, for better or worse, new beginnings. And maybe we can be hopeful that COVID will finally be taken care of, eradicated, and that we can get back to a normal life. So my intention, doesn't have to be yours, for today will be hopeful. And that's what I used as my intention during my practice this morning. But we're gonna get started. We're gonna warm the body up. We're gonna get started, like I always do, with juicy joints, exercise tool number one. Let me get the music going and off we'll go. Okay, here we go. So exercise tool number one, juicy joints. We're gonna juice up our joints. I do see a couple of new people in here. Welcome. Welcome to Ageless Grace, Brain Health, and let's get going. Any problems, call the desk upstairs. So let's start moving our legs. Arch those hands, hug those arms. Warming up the knees and the elbows. Juicy joints. Arms up, shoulders. Up, up. If you have an issue with your shoulders, just feel it moderate. Everything can be modified. Out. Hips. Out, in, out, in. Arms extended, rotating those wrists, circle. circle.
You know you make me roll up that
circle. Circle the other way. Extend that leg. Point. And bring it in and let's march. Arms up. Keep going. Warming up that body to the side. Okay. In and out. Push, 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 push. Press. 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 All right, let's pump those arms, move those legs. Out, in, out, in. Making the brain work opposite side. Up, up, shout. Push. Press. Good, march it down. So I actually can see a couple of you, and I just want to reemphasize that this is a chair class, barefoot chair class. We're incorporating our muscles in a completely different way than if we were standing. It forces the brain to actually work in a different way. So if you're standing, I'm asking you to find a chair and have a seat, because you get a whole different experience from it. Okay, here we go. Exercise tool number two, dive in. Always 1 foot forward for balance. We will switch off. Here we go. Hold your nose. Jump in.
He was afraid to come out of the
water. Jumping in the water. Switch feet and hands. Good. Get ready. We're going to breaststroke. 1 foot forward to balance. To the right. To the center. To the left. Center, switch those feet. And crawl. Swimming across the pool. All right, side stroke to the right. Side stroke. Other side. Side stroke. Good. Back to the center. So since this is tool called dive in, we're going to dive. Dive. 1 foot forward. Switch feet. Dive in. Dive. All right, let's do a backstroke. And kicking our feet. And crawl, kicking those feet. Let's dive 1 foot forward. Dive in. Dive in. Other foot, dive. Good. water. Very, very important to keep hydrated. Their brain functions best with water. Okay, exercise tool number three, spelling bee, B for body. Today we're going to spell the word hopeful, since that's the word that I picked for my intention. And since it's my class, we're going to spell the word hopeful. So for those of you that have never been here before, there's a couple of names I don't recognize. What we do is we write forward and we write backward. We print, we use script, really gets the brain. So this is a real exercise for the brain, but we use our body to spell. So today the word is hopeful. So everybody in your head, spell the word hopeful to yourself, and then we'll get going. Hopeful. So we're going to start with big capital letters with our right hand. Here we go, in print, hopeful. Hopeful. Big capital letters. Hopeful. Let's go with our left foot. Hopeful. Big capital letters. Hopeful. So far, pretty easy. Hopeful. Let's take our left hand. Spell hopeful backwards. Here we go. Capital letters. Hopeful backwards. And then we're switching to the right and in script, in cursive, hopeful, small letters, cursive. Let's go backwards as soon as you get to the end. Yell, spell it backwards, script. Good, hopeful. Let's take that right leg and in script, spell hopeful. Here we go.
Up and down with the eyebrows.
angry. Make an angry face. And a sad face. Sad face. But we always come back to our smile. Smile. And from smile, let's go to joy. Joy. Joyful. All right, let's raise those eyebrows up again. Sheets at home. We're going to do sports. fresh air. And I'm sure everybody played sports at one time in their life. So we're reaching back into our childhood, which is a lot of what Ageless Grace is about. Reaching back, replenishing the neurons, doing things that we haven't done in 30 or 40 years that builds those neurons up and replenishes them and repairs. So I'm just going to take a quick drink. Talking and dancing. So we're going to play some sports. Here we go. Basketball. Let's start with basketball. It's basketball season. Right hand dribble. Left hand dribble. Baseball, grab the bat. Here we go. do for your body that take you outside of your Parkinson's. So this tool, Shake It Up Baby, is designed with that in mind. The more you shake, the more you move your body, the more you're taken outside of your body's tremors or whatever it is that you're dealing with. And for those of you that don't struggle with that or have any other health issues, it's just going to be great exercise. So here we go. Move those feet. Move those legs. Move the arms. Shake it up, baby. Let's bring the arms to the center and bring them up. And the center. Good. Shake the head. Shake that head. Shake those arms. Shake the body. Shake the feet. And twist. Shake it all. Shake it up, baby. Bring it up. So you see it, my legs and arms are going in opposite directions. Opposite. Now we're going to go the same side. Same, 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 same. Opposite. Same, 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 opposite. Let's do it again. Same. Opposite. Okay, shake those hands. Shake those arms. Shake that head. Shake your neck. Shake your shoulders. Shake your booty. Shake your legs. Shake your feet. Shake it all. Twist and shout. Take it down. 1 foot forward. Take it up. Switch those feet out. Take it down. Take it up. Shake it up, baby. Shake the hands. Shake the head. Shake the arms, the shoulders, the booty, and the legs. Yeah. Good. Woo! Getting a workout here, huh? Definitely a good workout. So catch your breath a little bit. We are going to tool number. Okay, this will give us a little rest. Tool number 4, front row orchestra. So everybody get your instruments ready. We're going to be performing at Carnegie Hall. So if you ever played an instrument, reach back into that instrument, that childhood. And if you never played an instrument, well, fake it like me, because I never played an instrument. Here we go. Let's start with our violin. With feeling, play that violin. Requiem for a Dream. And in our orchestra, we switch sides. Ageless Grace. Good. And if this foot is forward, your left, switch to your right. Piano. Everybody play the piano. Feel it. It's your concert. Let's play some drums. Tap your foot if you want. Drums. And a cymbal. Switch your feet. Playing those drums. Cymbal on the other side. You can feel those neurons firing. Let's play a harp.
Switch.
One foot is always a forward for balance. I don't care which one. Soaring down. We're going to catch a fish. And we're going to become a fish. Exhale, slow. Tool number 20, get up, get down. Okay, so you had a little rest. Get up, get down is exactly what it sounds like. It's the one tool that you can get out of your chair, but you don't have to get out of your chair. Everything can be modified, so if you don't want to get up, get down, you can get up and get down. Okay? Here we go. Get ready. You're not getting up yet, but get ready. Right arm, right leg. Up and down. Right arm, right leg. Knee up, arm up. Get up, get down, right? Switch sides. Here we go.
Up now with those heels.
that, let them know that you're getting yourself quite a workout while you're taking this class. Okay. Gentle geometry, tool number 9 for the brain. So what we do with gentle geometry is we use shapes, triangles, circles, lines. With our arms and our legs, we mix it all up and we make a big mess. So here we go. If you need a drink of water or a breath, take one. Gentle geometry. Here we go. Right arm. Circle. Right arm circle. Good. You got this. Right arm circle. Left arm straight line. Good. Okay. Circle on the left. Straight up and down on the right. Here we go. Okay. Pretty easy, right? We're going to take that left and make it a triangle. Here we go. Circle on one, triangle on the other. Don't quit, no matter what. This is what makes your brain work better than anything. This is what fires your neurons. Circle, straight line on the right, triangle on the left. Here we go. Maybe a little easier than the circle. Okay, everybody have that? Let's make a circle with our right leg while we're doing this, okay? That's where it got me. Okay, shake it out. Left arm up and down. Right arm side to side. Ten minutes a day of this. For brain health. 10 minutes a day. Switch sides up and down. Side to side. Up and down on the right. Side to side on the left. Let's make a circle with that left. And a triangle with our left foot. Don't follow me. I'm getting better, but 10 minutes a day. Okay, circle with that right. Triangle with the left. And you're getting quite a workout with those arms, too. Circle on the right, triangle on the left. Switch, circle on the left. Triangle on the right. Oh, boy. All right, circle, opposite. Counterclockwise and clockwise, and then take it the other way. Okay. Pretty challenging. So that's one of the most challenging I find, and I just lost my place here, so. Number 7, Yo Baby, which is Ageless Grace's version of yoga. And this is where I do my, for those of you that have taken the class, we do intentions and gratitude. So everybody, let's just take a couple of breaths, because actually there is a tool, number 16, breathe out loud. So let's just close our eyes and take a couple of breaths and exhale. And take another one. And let's go into our yo baby. So deep breath in, reaching the arms up to the sky, hands together through the heart. Let's do it again. Reaching up to the sky, hands together through the heart. Let's close our eyes. And we're going to set an intention for this little yo baby practice. It can be hope, it can be joy, it can be peace, it can be anything that you want it to be. So set an intention. And after you set your intention, think of something you're grateful for. Every day, gratitude, something that you're grateful for. And then we'll open our eyes, taking one more deep breath and reaching up, hands to the heart, 1 foot forward, arms down, and we're reaching straight out into our warrior one. Reaching out, like we're going to grab onto the universe, hands down, switch feet, reaching out, warrior one. Bring the foot in, turning slightly to the right in the chair, extending that right arm out and then the left. Looking out over your right hand. This is warrior two. What you see beyond that hand is in your imagination. What do you see? Hands together at the heart, turning forward, and then turning to the other direction, extending the left arm and the right arm out, looking out over your fingers. What do you see? This is where the brain uses its imagination. Hands come together at the heart again, facing forward, deep breath in. Hands together, reaching back ever so slightly in a back bend. And then 1 foot forward, arms come down. Breathing in, reaching back up, switching feet. Arms come down. The feet come in, we open our legs, we reach our right hand down. A left arm comes up, it feels comfortable. And we look up at that hand. Only if it feels good. Left hand comes down. And we reach with the right. The triangle. Looking up to the sky. Hands come down. Deep breath in. Hands together. At the heart. Close your eyes. Remembering that intention that we said at the beginning of this little yo baby. What was your intention? What was your gratitude? Opening our eyes. With our hands at our heart, let's wish one another. Namaste. Beverly, Irwin, Marilyn, Ann, Barbara, Murrow, and whoever else is there. Namaste. Peace. Wishing you joy, love, hope, and peace. Have a beautiful day. Namaste. Hopefully I'll see you all next week. Thank you, Anne. Can't hear you.